Okay, so we have 33 students now, so we are going to start the lecture again, and this is going to be chapter number 3. Chapter number 3 is about factors and multiples. Okay, what is chapter 3? Chapter 3 is factors and multiples. Okay,
yes. Class?
Okay, so look, what happens is, I'll give you a very quick example. I'll just mute everyone so that you can ask a question when you want to, okay? Ahmed, do you have any question, beta? Ahmed Ali? Ahmed Ali, you have any? Okay. Okay, so class, what we are going to do is, I'm going to give you a quick example. Look, just pay attention and listen to this example, okay? Suppose you have a group of 6 stars, okay? You have a group of 6 stars. Okay, look. Now, if I say that you have to arrange these 6 stars in different ways, okay, in different ways, or I can say that you have to make groups, okay, equal groups means that you have to make groups with equal number of stars in it, okay. So, what you can do is, look, if you are arranging, what you can do is you can arrange it like this as well. Okay. These are 6 stars. Now what you did is, this is called a row. This horizontal is called a row. What you did is, you put 6 stars in one row. Okay. You put 6 stars in one row. This is one group. So you have total 6 stars. Okay. I can see on chat, people are sending me message, 2 groups and 3 groups. Very good. Okay. Now, the second example is C. Now, how many groups we have made here? We have made 3 groups, 3 rows. Okay. This 1 row, 2 row, 3 row. Every row has 2 stars. So this is one group of 2 stars. This is a second group of 2 stars. And then this last one is the third group of 2 stars. So 2 stars per row in 3 rows are 6 stars again. Okay. Now we can also make, okay, just wait, okay. Okay, now we can also make 2 groups of 3 stars, okay. This one group of 3 stars and then second group of 3 stars. So this is total 6 stars again. So look, there are number of ways in which you can arrange these 6 stars, okay. Now, one thing, remember this, the first one which we did, look at the first one again, okay. This was one group of 6 stars, okay? I put 6 stars in one line, in one row, okay? We are talking about the row. One row is one group. So this was one group. Now look at this example, last example again. Last example, this one, okay? Now I have put 6 stars in different rows, okay? So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 rows. And 1 star per row. So this means that we are making 6 groups. Okay. Okay. Now what you can do is, look, you can say that 6 is equals to 1 multiplied by 6, 1 group with 6 stars, then 2 groups with 3 stars, 3 groups of 2 stars, and 6 groups of 1 star. So what you can say is that 6 can be written as a product of 2 numbers in many ways. Okay. 6 is equals to 1 into 6, 2 into 3, 3 into 2, and 6 into 1. So these 1, 2, 3, and 6, these are the exact divisors of 6. What do we mean by exact divisor? Listen carefully. The exact divisor means that when you divide this 6 by 1, when you divide this 6 by 1, the answer is going to be 6. This means that 1 divides 6 exactly. There is no remainder. Okay. If I say, for example, if I say divide 8 by 2. Okay. If you divide 8 by 2, if you divide 8 by 2, the answer is going to be 4. Okay. So that's a whole number. This means it is an exact divisor. There is no remainder. Okay, now class, if you please open your books on page number 32. Open on page number 32. Everyone, please open your books on page number 32. Okay, quickly. Okay, before we go on to the book, look at another example here. Okay, look. If anyone has missed the first example, if anyone missed the first example, look at the second. What we are going to do is we are going to arrange a number of products or a number of things. Look, we have 8 footballs here. 8 footballs we have to arrange in different ways. Now, what I can do is I can arrange all 8 footballs in one row. So this is one group of 8 balls. Okay. Then what I can do is I can make 2 groups of 4 balls each. So 4 balls in first group, 4 balls in second group. So I can say there are 2 rows of 4 balls. Okay. 2 rows of 4 balls each, or 2 groups in which one group has 4 balls. Okay. Then the third can be, we can make 4 groups of 2 balls. These are 4 groups of 2 balls. First group with 2 balls. This is the second group with 2 balls. Then there's third group, and then there's fourth group. Okay, so lastly we can do is we can make 8 groups. So 8 groups of 1 ball each. Okay, 8 rows, 1 row, 2nd row, 3rd row, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th. So we have made 8 rows and each row has 1 ball. So what you can do is, if it is asked the factors of you have to write the product of 8, you can write it as 1 into 8, 2 into 4. Okay, this means 2 groups with 4 balls each. Okay, then 4 into 2, and then 8 into 1. Okay, class, look carefully that you cannot write, you cannot make 3 groups, or you cannot make a group with 3 balls. Why? Look, if I make a group of 3 balls each, okay, so in the first group there will be 3 balls, in the second group there will be 3 balls again. The total number of balls now are 6. Now how many balls are remaining? Only 2. Okay, I am going to unmute you all. Okay, so but please I want everyone to participate, but please don't make unnecessary noise. Okay, okay, so class, what I am saying is that if I make a group of 3 balls, the first group will have 3 balls, second group will have 3 balls again. So the total number of balls are now 6. How many balls are remaining? 2 balls only. So you cannot make another group of 3 balls, right?
Because it will be not equal.
Yes, it will not be equal. You have to make equal groups. So now,
yes sir,
this means that you cannot make a group of 3 balls, or you cannot make 3 groups. This also means that 8 is not divisible by,
sir,
3.
Sir, we make 2 groups of 4 football.
Yeah, we have made 2 groups of 4 balls, or 4 groups of 2 balls, but we cannot do it with number 3. Why? Because 8 is not divisible by 3.
By 3.
Right? This means, what this means, that 8 does not come in the table of 3, right?
Three.
So if 8 doesn't come in the table of 3,
are you explaining or doing then, work?
Beta, I'm just explaining. Listen carefully, okay? So
okay.
So now, that's why we did it. First, we made 1 group, then we made 2 groups, then we made 4 groups, and then we made 8 groups. So we can say that here, we can say that 1, 2, 4, and 8. They are the exact divisors of 8. Exact divisors of 8 means that if you divide 8 by 1, or if you divide 8 by 2, or if you divide 8 by 4, or if you divide 8 by 8, the answer is going to be a whole number and there is no remainder. Okay, class, any questions? Anyone has any question? Please raise your hand, okay? Please raise your hand if anyone has any question.
No, sir.
No,
Okay, let's move forward. Those of you who have late, who have joined the class late, I don't know why you guys have joined the class late. We are doing chapter number 3. We have just started.
Yeah, Okay.
So listen carefully. We are doing chapter number 3 on page number 31 and 32. We haven't done anything from the book right now. We haven't done anything in the copy. I'm just explaining. I'm just explaining the basic things how we will make equal groups. Okay. So now,
if you move forward,
we have only done this right now. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, look, class. If I say 7 divides 28 exactly and gives question 4 and remainder 0. Look, 7 divides 28. This means 28 divided by 7. Okay. So the answer is answer is 4. This answer is called quotient. Everyone remembers this. We did it in the last class of chapter 2 when we were doing the rules of division. Okay. So this 28 is called the dividend. 7 is called the divisor and 4 is called the quotient.
Quotient.
Okay, good, Alian. So now, if 7 divides 28 exactly, the answer is 4. There is no remainder. Okay, class. Okay, now, similarly, you can say that 4 divides 28 exactly and gives question 7. So if you divide 28 by 4, the answer is 7. Remainder is 0. Okay, this is just basic division that we are doing right now. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, now 28 can also be divided by 28. Right? So if any number is divided by the same number, the answer is always 1. If you divide any number by the same number, if you divide any number by itself, the answer is always 1. Okay. Okay, class, look carefully now. Okay, class, so now if you divide 28 by 1, you can divide 28 by 2 also. Okay, the answer is 14. Then if you divide 28 by 4, the answer is 7. If you divide 28 by 7,
but just, sir, just aapne first 3 likhe un sab ko hi fir aage 1 aur 28 ko shuffle aage piche kar dein to fir same aa jayega.
Okay, first of all, Subhayal, you all have to speak in English, okay? You all have to speak in English. I am tired of please saying this again and again that you all have to speak in English, okay? Okay, now listen carefully first. Let me explain this and then you can ask a question, okay? Okay, now if I, these are the numbers 1, 2, 4, 7, 14 and 28. These numbers are the exact divisors of 28. These numbers are the exact divisors of 28. So I can say that 1, 2, 4, 7, 14 and 28 are the exact divisors of 28. If you take any number, other than these 6 numbers, you cannot divide 28 by that number. There will always be a remainder. There will always be a remainder. Okay. Okay, so please open chapter 3, page number 31, 32. Okay, we haven't done anything from the book. Okay, now when a number is the exact divisor, Walaikum Salaam. When a number is the exact divisor of a number, for example, we saw here that 1, 2, 4, 7, 14, and 28 are exact divisors of 28. We can say that these numbers are the factors of 28. We can say that these numbers are the factors of the number 28. Right? So what are factors? Look on page number 33. Page number 33 of your books.
Sir, I know what is factor.
Sir, except one, every number will always have two factors.
Okay, we'll discuss that later, Subhayal. Okay, there is a little bit of confusion in that part. I'll explain you later when we move on to that part. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So now, Page number 33, everyone, please open page number 33. There is this green box. Now read it with me. A number that divides another number completely without leaving a remainder is a factor of that number. Now look, if you see that example in your book, above this green box, you can see 35 is written as 7 multiplied by 5. Okay, 35 is equals to 7 multiplied by 5. And if you divide 35 by 7, the answer is going to be 5. And if you divide 35 by 5, the answer is going to be anyone? If you divide 35 by
7,
5,
sir.
Yes, very
seven.
Good. So if you divide 35 by 5, the answer is going to be 7. There is no remainder. Okay. So,
yes.
So you can say that 7 and 5 are factors of 35, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now if you look at the next paragraph, 35 can also be written like this, 1 multiplied by 35. So
five.
This means 1 and 35 are also factors of 35.
Okay? Yes.
Okay, now one thing that I want everyone to remember, this definition in the green box is very important. You guys have you guys have to remember this definition. Okay. If we have any test, I am going to tell you that in the test, this definition can come in many different ways. In three or four different ways, you can have this definition. Okay, class. So look at the green box again. A number that divides another number completely without leaving a remainder. For example, a number that divides, I say 5. 5 divides 25 completely, right? If you divide 25 by 5, the answer is going to be 5. There is going to be no remainder. So a number that divides another number completely without leaving a remainder is a factor of that number. Like we saw when we were dividing 35 divided by 7.
But then 5 will be the factor of 25.
Yes. So when you divide 35 divided by 7, the answer was coming 5. So you can say 7 is a factor of 35. Okay.
Sir, जैसे आपने पीछे दिखाया था 1-2 footballs का उनमें सारे वो जो थे
वो factors थे.
Factors थे.
Okay. So भैया please English बेटा please English.
Okay sir.
Acha class, now look, 16 divided by 1 is 16, 16 divided by 2 is 8. Now, okay, I have divided by 1, I divided by 2. Now, can I divide 16 by 3? Can I divide 16 by 3?
No, sir.
Okay, so the...
Sir, you can divide, but... sir, you can divide, but... there will be remainder.
Okay.
So
if I have to divide 16 exactly without any remainder, I cannot divide it by 3.
Okay? Sir.
So 16 divided by 3 is not possible.
We divide by 4.
Okay. So next what we do is we check number 4. 16 divided by 4 is 4.
4.
Okay. Now then we move forward 5, 6, 7 and we come to 8. 16 divided by 8 is 2.
Two.
Then you move forward and the last one is 16. So 1,
yes.
2, 4 and 8 and 16. 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16 are the exact divisors of 16. So
yes.
We can say that 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16 are the factors of 16.
Factor of 16.
Okay. Yes. Achha, ab,
yes, sir.
Ab, now I will explain it to you in a very easy way. Okay. A very easy way is... Dekho, if 16 is coming in any table, 16 comes
yes.
in the table of 1, 16 comes in the
yes.
table of 2, 16 comes in the table of 4, 8 and 16. Jiske bhi table mein aayega, that number is going to be the factor of 16. Theek hai? If 16 is coming in the table of any number, we will say that number is the factor of 16. Clear class? Everyone clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is called this is
no,
called
sir.
Factor. Okay, anyone has any question? Please ask.
सर एक और दफा समझा दे.
ओके आई विल एक्सप्लेन व्हेन यू आस्क इन इंग्लिश बिलाल. ओके इफ यू आस्क मी इन इंग्लिश आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अगेन.
सर प्लीज एक्सप्लेन अगेन.
ओके आई विल एक्सप्लेन अगेन. Okay, class. Look. Okay, who asked this question? Who is asking this question to explain again?
Sir, Mustafiz.
Bilal. Bilal. Okay, Bilal. Look carefully, beta. Look, what I am saying is, if I am dividing 16 by 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16, the answers are coming in whole numbers, right? ठीक है. नाउ इफ आई से 16 डिवाइडेड बाय 3, इफ यू डिवाइड 16 बाय 3 देयर इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू बी अ रिमाइंडर. ओके नाउ लुक आई विल गिव यू बिलाल व्हाट यू डू इज गो ऑन टू पेज नंबर 32. इफ यू लुक ऑन पेज नंबर 32 क्लास एवरीवन प्लीज गो ऑन पेज नंबर 32. ओके दिस इज इफ यू सी यू कैन सी दैट देयर इज अ वर्किंग इन बिटवीन वेयर दे आर डिवाइडिंग 87 बाय 5. There is a division example. They are dividing 87 by 5. Bilal, can you see beta on page number 32?
Yes, sir.
Okay, look what is happening when they are dividing 87 by 5. The answer above is coming 17, but there is a remainder.
Yes, sir.
The remainder is 2. Look, whenever there is a remainder, this means that we cannot divide 87 by 5 exactly.
So it exactly. means that number is not the factor of.
Yes. So, Bilal, what do I mean is you cannot divide 87 by 5 exactly. Exactly means that the remainder is 0. So, when you cannot divide a number exactly by 5, this means that 5 is not a factor of that number. Okay. So, yahan what we can say is 5 is not a factor of 87. Okay, Bilal? Do you understand this so far?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now look at this example on your screen. The example of number 16. Okay. Look now. 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16. These all are the exact divisors of 16. What do you mean by exact divisor? That when you divide 16 by these numbers, there is no remainder. Okay, Bilal?
Factors of.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So when the numbers are dividing 16 exactly, these numbers are going to be the factors of 16. Clear now, Bilal?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now moving forward to the definition. Okay, a factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. Okay? A factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. Just like I told you that number 8 was the exact divisor of 16. In the previous example, number 8 was exact divisor of 16. So you can say 8 is a factor of 16. Okay, this means the factor leaves remainder 0 when it divides a number. The remainder is always going to be 0. Okay, if anyone has any question, please raise your hand.
No.
If anyone has any question, raise your hand.
No, sir.
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay.
Sir, I have understand very
well.
Okay, class, please rejoin. Please rejoin. Anyone?
Sir, आपने कहा था कि आप टेस्ट लेंगे.
Test is tomorrow. Everyone rejoin.
Okay, sir.
Sir, chapter 2 का ना?
Okay, class. We are waiting for everyone to join. Okay, just 2 more minutes. Everyone, please wait 2 more minutes. Let everyone join.
Yes, sir.
Then we'll continue with the lecture. Okay, tomorrow test is of chapter 2. Tomorrow test is of chapter 2.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I'm very glad okay. that everyone is rejoining the class, but a lot of you are not participating in the class. A lot of you students, I only see 4 or 5 students who talk in the class and who ask questions and all. So everyone, please try to participate as much as possible. Okay, participation counts. Okay.
Sir, aapne present laga li.
Better, yes, I'll mark the attendance. Don't worry about it. Okay, whoever is rejoining the class, whoever is rejoining the class, they will be marked present. Don't worry about
it. मैं लिख रही हूँ थोड़ी देर रुक जाए. Sir, have you marked my attendance?
Yes, beta. I am going to mark all the attendances. Don't worry about the attendances right now. Okay, I think everyone has joined. Okay, so now look at this definition again. So a number, a factor of a number, is an exact divisor of that number. Okay, we did this in the last slide. We saw that the numbers were exactly dividing 16, 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16. There was no remainder. So we say those numbers are the factor of 16. Okay. Okay, class. Now you have to learn how to find factor. Okay. You have to learn how to find a factor. So these are some steps that you need to understand. Okay, these are very easy steps. Like when I was explaining you right now the examples of 16, the example of 8 and other numbers, we were already doing these steps. There is only going to be one or two additional steps that are going
to
make that
process easier. These are the steps of finding factor.
Yes, of finding factor. Okay, so I'll make it very easy for you. Okay, Iman Fatma, beta, I know there is a load shedding problem everywhere these days, so don't worry, you have not missed much. Just remember that we are doing factors and multiples today. So how to find factors we are going to do today. Okay, now look, first step is you start with the number 1. Okay, suppose example we have to find the factors of 16. Okay, now when you have to find the factors of 16, what we are going to do is, first we will start with the number 1. Okay, then we will try 2, 3, 4 and all numbers that come after 1. Okay, now how far we can go, you have to stop somewhere. Now there is a sign which will tell you that you have to stop here. What is that sign? Let's look. When you repeat your factors, cross out the repeat. Now what does this mean? Look at the example. I was writing the factors of 16. Now I started with 1. The first factors I will write is 1 multiplied by 16. Okay. Now please listen carefully, class. When I write 1 multiplied by 16, this means that 1 and 16 both are factors of 16. 1 and 16 are both are the factors of 16. Then after number 1, the second step was we move on to the next number. Next number is 2. Now I will write 2 8s are 16. Okay. 2 8s are 16. We know that 2 8s are 16. How I got this? I will divide 16 by 2. When I'm finding factors of 16, I am dividing it by 2. I get 8. So 2 8s are 16. There is no remainder. So I can say 2 and 8 are also factor of 16s. Okay, now we will move to number 3. Now if I divide 16 by 3, there is going to be a remainder. Okay, because 3 5s are 15. 3 6s are 18. There is no 16 in the table of 3. So there is always going to be a remainder. There is always going to be a remainder when I divide 16 by 3. So 3 is not a factor. Everyone, please tell me if you don't understand anything. Okay, you understand this? The 3 is not a factor of 16. So we will leave 3 out of it.
It can be a divisor, but it is not a factor.
Yes, it is not a factor. Factor will always be when it is dividing exactly. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we will move to number 4. Number 4 is 4 4s are 16. Right, class? 4 4s are 16. Now look, the next rule that you have to learn is, if you get doubles such as 4 by 4, you will stop there. Okay, you will stop there. This means now we have all the factors. Now look, class. Look
it
at
is
the
end
line.
Of the point.
Yes, now we were finding factors. First, what we did is we started with the number 1, then we moved on to 3, then you move on to 3, then you move on to 4, then you move on to 5, 6 and so on. But you will stop when the numbers are repeating or when you get a double. So now in this case, you got a double, 4 into 4. We will stop here. Now how to find factors? Now look, this 1 is a factor, 16 is a factor, 2 is a factor, 8 is a factor and 4 is a factor. Now you cannot write 4 twice, okay? You have already written 4, so you cannot write 4 twice. So 4 4s are 16 means 4 is a factor of 16. So what are the factors of 16? 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. Okay? Look at another example. Number 7. We are finding factors of 7. We first start with number 1. Okay, what is the first step? You start with?
Sir, it will be 1 and 7.
1 into 7. Okay, now what is the next step? Anyone can tell me what is the next step? Okay, I will ask myself. Okay, wait. 14. No, wait. Alina Malik, can you hear me, beta? Alina Malik.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Alina, can you tell me what was the next step? First, we started with number 1. What is the next step? Alina? What is the next step, Alina?
Sir?
Okay, Abira.
Sir, we got the 7 is a prime number.
Abira Mujahid? Abira Mujahid? Okay, we will move on to the next number. Number 2. Okay.
Sir, 7 is a prime number.
Alian, beta, please wait. Listen to the next step, okay? First step is to always start with number 1. Then the next step is you check other numbers. Number 2. Now 7 is not, now 2 is not a divisor of 7. Okay? You cannot divide 7 by 2. Right? Because there is always going to be a remainder. So 2 is not a factor. Similarly, 3 is also not a factor. 4 is not a factor. 5 is not a factor. 6 is not a factor. Why are 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are not factors of 7? Abdul Mois will tell. Abdul Mois? Okay, Abdul Mois.
Sir, can I tell?
No, Laiba Asad will tell. Laiba Asad.
Sir, 7 and 1. Sir, the last one is the multiple.
No. Laiba, my question is. Beta, Laiba, listen to my question first, Laiba, okay? My question is okay. Why is 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 are not factors of 7? Why 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are not factors of 7?
Sir, because if you divide 7 by these numbers, there will be a remainder.
Very good. Very nice, okay? So whenever you divide a number by another number and there is a remainder, that number is not a factor. But now we move on to number 7. Now class, listen carefully. When we come on to number 7, we know 7 ones are 7. Now we are not going to go to number 8. Now two reasons. First reason is, now the number is repeated. First we wrote 1 multiplied by 7 and now we are writing 7 multiplied by 1. This means they are repeating. So whenever the numbers are repeating, we will stop there. Okay, class? Any question?
No, Laiba? Sir.
Laiba?
No, sir.
Okay. Okay, class, look now. Page number 33. Page number 33, just below the green box, you can say the factors of 10 are 1, 2, 5 and 10. Everyone, page number 33. I'm going to end the class now. So page number 33, just look at page number 33. There are two rules written below this. Everyone can see, look at the factors of the number 10 to 7. Two points should be noted. Everyone can see these two points. Page number 33,
yes,
class.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, underline. Can I read? Underline these two rules. Okay, Alian, read. Alian. Only the 2 points.
Sir, point one is a factor of every number. Point two, every number is a factor of itself.
Okay, now listen carefully, class. One is a factor of every number. Okay, if you divide any number by one, there is not going to be a remainder. So one is always going to be a factor of every number. ठीक है?
Okay.
Now point number two. Point number two is saying that every number is a factor of itself. Look, we saw it in the last examples when we were finding the factors of 16. One of the factors was number 16 itself. When we were finding the factor of number 7, one of the factors was the number 7 itself. Okay, why? Because if you divide any number by itself, the answer is always going to be 1. If you divide 7 by 7, the answer is going to be 1.
Malik.
If you divide 32 by 32, the answer is going to be 1. This means that the number itself is also a factor of itself. So if I say that 7 is a factor of 7, that is true. If I say 99 is a factor of 99, that is also true. So you have to remember these two points. Please underline or highlight these two points in your book. Everyone, please highlight or underline or mark these two points. These two points are very important. These can come in your test in future when I'm going to take test of chapter 3. These two points can come in the test also. So you have to remember these two things. One is a factor of every number, and number two, every number is a factor of it. Self.
Okay. Sir, what is today's homework?
Beta, I am going to tell the homework. First, please pay attention to what we are doing. Okay. Okay, now class. Okay, now look this on the screen. If I write 4 multiplied by 5 is equals to 20, I can say that 4 and 5 are factors of 20. Right, class? 4 and 5 are factors of 20. And 20 is a multiple of 4 and 5. What is a multiple? Multiple is any number that can be divided by a number. If I say that 20 is divisible by 4, this means that 4 is a factor of 20 and 20 is a multiple of 4. Okay, class? Whenever a number is divided by another number and there is no remainder, for example, if I divide 20 by 4, there is going to be no remainder. I can say that 4 is a factor of 20 and 20 is a multiple of 4. Right, class?
Yes, sir.
Okay, similarly, 2 into 12 is 24. So 2 and 12 are factors of 24 and 24 is a multiple of 2 and 12. So a number is a multiple of its factors. Mm-hmm. Okay. If 2 and 12 are factors of 24, so 24 is a multiple of 2 and 12. Very simple. Right? Anyone has any questions?
Sir, 4 is a factor of 24?
Yes, 4 is a factor of 24.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so we did multiple. Okay. We have done multiple. A multiple of any number is a number obtained by multiplying that number by any natural number. This means if I multiply 4 and 5 and I get 20, I can say that 20 is a multiple of 4. Okay. This is very easy. Okay. Okay, class, what we will do is just look at this, these points to remember. Okay, we'll do this later. Let's end the class today. I'm just going to give you a little bit of work. Okay, I'm not going to give homework because I want everyone to revise for chapter 2. You have the test tomorrow, chapter 2. So some students are saying they want to revise, so no homework. So there will be no homework, and I'm going to write it on the chat. Okay, everyone, please look at the chat. No homework. Prepare for chapter 2 test tomorrow. So tomorrow is your test of chapter 2. I want everyone to prepare. Okay, at the beginning of the class, I gave you all a little bit of hint that all of you please read the properties carefully. Read all the properties carefully, the additive identities, the commutative property, associative property, distributive property, closure property. I want everyone to read those properties. Yes, I want everyone to read those properties. I want everyone to read those properties carefully. because I am going to give questions from those properties as well. Second thing, we did question 4 and 6 in exercise 2B, and we did question 3 also. Those questions are also very important. Question 7 is important. So I'm going to give you questions like those. Okay. Then multiple choice questions too. I'm going to give that as well. Okay, class. So thank you very much. Okay, and sir, I hope everyone has understood.
Sir, can we leave?
Tomorrow we are going to do the test in class. Okay. Tomorrow we will do the test in class. I will tell you how we have to do it and how you have to submit the answers. So tomorrow, please make sure that all of you are present on time. Okay, and when we are done with the test, we will do a short review of factor and multiple, and then we can move on to exercise 3A question 1 and 2 as well. Okay.
Yes,
sir.
Okay, now anyone who wants to leave can leave. Allah Hafiz, and anyone who has questions can stay and ask the question. Himayal Fatma, you have any question, beta?
Allah Hafiz, sir.
Allah Hafiz, sir.
Allah Hafiz, sir.
Allah Hafiz, everyone. Allah Hafiz. Okay. Himayal, I cannot hear you clearly. Just wait, beta. Just wait. Okay, now unmute yourself and ask, beta. Himayal.
Sir, I am asking that the one that you have written on screen, we have to do it or not?
What thing, beta?
You had write the multiples and the question and the answers.
No, beta, you don't have to write anything right now, okay?
Just okay. Revising is what?
Yes, you just have to revise chapter number 2. Tomorrow is the test, okay?
Okay, sir, Allah Hafiz.
Okay, anyone else has any question?
Sir, Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz, beta, Allah Hafiz. Okay, anyone else has any question? No. Okay, class, so Allah Hafiz, everyone. Stay safe, stay home.